tunasema ni asanti kwa wema na fadhili zako. Tunasema ni asanti kwa maana wewe ni Mungu na haubadiliki. Katika jina la Yesu Kristo. Whatever you are watching us from, I want us to share even in the word of prayer in the name of Jesus Christ. I want us to share in the book of Ephesians chapter 6. Ephesians chapter 6. And tutabarikiwa sana. From verses 12, Ephesians chapter 6, from verses 12. But wacha nianzie tu mstari wa 10. King James Version Bible says, "Finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Put on the whole armor of God, that you may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For we do not wrestle against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against rulers of the darkness of the age, against spiritual hosts of wickedness in the heavenly places. Therefore, take up the whole armor of God, that you may be able to withstand in the days of in the evil day, and having done all to stand." The Bible talks about wearing the full armor, or putting the full armor, so that we can be able to stand in the evil day. There is this evil day that is coming. There is this end time days that are coming. We are in those days that we were hearing about, where we are hearing crisis everywhere. We are hearing fights everywhere. But I want to tell you this, only the remnant will stand. Who are the remnant? The remnant are the people who will be able to wear the full armor of the Lord. Ni watu ambao wataweza kuvaa mavazi ambayo inastahili katika jina la Yesu. Kwa maana mimi nasema kwamba Paulo akiandikia Waefeso akamwambia kwamba hatupigani na mwili. We don't fight against flesh, but we fight against principalities. We fight against powers. Tunapigana kinyume na madhabahu. Tunapigana kinyume na maroho. Tunapigana kinyume na nguvu za anga. Na nataka kukutangazia kila nguvu ambayo unapigana nayo, wewe utaweza kuishinda. Wewe utaweza kuishinda katika jina la Yesu Kristo. Mahali ulipo, mahali unanitazama ukiwa, nataka uinue mikono na uweze kuomba. Mwambie Mungu siku ya leo, kila ngome ambayo inajaribu kujiinua, every demonic stronghold that is trying to lift it itself, die by fire, die by fire. Rikama sekere batana bahanda rikayanda na mushanda na muzaya. Come on, lift up your hands and pray. Abia Mungu siku ya leo, abia Bwana siku ya leo. Whatever is the stronghold, whatever is the stronghold, I command it to fall down and die. Zile pembe zinajiinua, zile pembe zinajiinua kupigana na maisha yangu mwezi wa January, kupigana na destiny yangu mwezi wa January. Fall down and die, fall down and die, fall down and die. Anguka na unaona pekaruke katika jina la Yesu Kristo. Kila kome inayojaribu kujiinua katika maisha yako, kila kome inajaribu kujiinua katika nyumba yako, na iamrisha katika jina la Yesu. Kila kome inayojaribu kujiinua, kuna kome ambayo inajaribu kuinua ndio usiweze kufaulu huo mwezi, ndio usifaulu mwaka wa 2022. Hiyo kome ndio naangusha, hiyo kome ndio naangusha katika jina la Yesu, katika jina la Yesu. We bring down every power, we bring down every altar, we bring down every evil altar, we bring down every evil altar in the name of Jesus. Makayanda rabo shandara kayanda rabo paruka zakara kayanda rabo mako zakara kayanda. Come on somebody pray. Mako zakara kayanda yekatara kayanda rabo saya akata rabo shandara rabo satara kayanda rekata rabo satara bahanda in the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus, listen to this. Listen to this. Verses 13, verses 14. Inasema kwamba tunasoma wenye wamekuja saa hii ni Ephesians chapter 6 verses from verses 10 to verses 14. Stand therefore, having guarded your waist with truth, having put on your waist with truth, ujiweke katika kiuno chako, uweke ukweli, ujiweke ukweli. The Bible says, and you shall know the truth, and the truth will set you free. Having put on the breastplate of righteousness. I do say most of the times righteousness is the light stand before God. Righteousness is the light stand before God. Any person who stands right in the presence of God, wakati mtu ameokoka, unahesabiwa kuwa haki, unakuwa righteous. Na kitu cha kwanza ndio Bwana akusikie mahali ulipo ni kuokoka, kwa sababu Mungu hawezi kukusikia ama huwezi kuwa na ushirika na Mungu kama hujaokoka. The Bible says in the book of John chapter 1 verse 12 that as many as have received him, he gave them power to become sons of God. Wale watu walipokea, walipewa nguvu za kuwa wana wa Mungu. Na kama wewe ni mwana, unaweza simama, unaweza hesabiwa haki mbele za Bwana. Next verse. That is, sasa tuko kwa miguu. And having shod your feet with the preparation of the gospel of peace. Katika miguu yako ukuwe umevaa viatu ambazo ni injili. Kama kuna kitu ambacho tuko na challenge siku ya leo ni watu wa kuhubiri injili. Wachungaji wamerudi makanisani, tumesahau kuendea watu ambao wako kule nje, tumesahau kuambia watu kuhusu Yesu ni mwema. Most of the research ambayo imefanywa juzi inaonyesha kwamba only 12% ya watu ambao wameokoka wanahubiri nje. Only 12%. And I want to tell you this, this is the time to take the gospel out. We have to wear the shoes in our feet, the shoes of the gospel. Wacha injili ya Mungu ikue ndio kiongozi, ndio taa. Neno la Mungu likuwe ndio taa katika maisha yako. Siku moja Petro Yesu akaambia wanafunzi wake awaoshe miguu, lakini Biblia inasema kwamba Petro akasema tuoshe hata mwili. Biblia inasema kwamba Yesu akamwambia kwamba nyinyi tayari ni wasafi kwa sababu mmelisikia hili neno. It is the word of God that cleanses you. It is the true gospel that cleanses you. Whatever you are, I want you to understand, any time that you are reading the word of God, any time that you are reading the Bible, you have been cleansed by that word. Lile neno limekuosha, lile neno limekufanya msafi, umekuwa msafi kwa ajili ya neno. Hallelujah. Tuendelee hiyo mstari mwingine tunapoendelea na maombi ya asubuhi. Rima shalaba katara mazuto rekayanda. Listen to this. Verses 16. Above all, I tell you, rima above all, taking the shield of faith with which you'll be able to quench all the fiery darts of the wicked one. Hallelujah. Above all, taking the shield of faith. The only shield that a Christian has is the shield of faith. And the only sword that we have is the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. You have to understand these two things. One, the shield that we have to protect us is faith. What is faith? According to the book of Hebrews chapter 11, that faith is a substance of things hoped for and an evidence of things not seen. It is a surety. It is a title deed. It is an evidence. It is like a logbook that shows that you are the owner of the car. And faith comes by hearing. The book of Romans, faith comes by by hearing and hearing the word of God. And I pray for your faith to grow in the name of Jesus. I say I pray for your faith to grow in the name of Jesus. Your faith will grow in Jesus' mighty name. Your faith will grow in Jesus' mighty name. Anything that is diminishing your faith, we bring it down in the name of Jesus. We bring it down in the name of Jesus. I declare that faith that comes from hearing the word of God. As you hear this word, I command your faith to grow. I say I command your faith to grow. As you hear this word, I command your faith to grow in the name of Jesus. The Bible says that we have the sword of the Spirit is the word of God, the shield that we have. There are so many arrows that the devil will put. There are so many arrows that the devil will throw. There are arrows of the deception. There are arrows of wrath. There are arrows of doubt. There are arrows of ignorance. But the shield that we have the shield of faith. We have the shield of faith. When you have faith, you are covered. You have the shield. No weapon fashioned against you can prosper, because any weapon, when it is thrown, any arrow of the devil, when it is thrown, it needs faith. When it encounters faith, it falls down. And I command any arrow that has been thrown to you, the arrow of diseases, the arrow of cancer, the arrow of high blood pressure, any kind of arrow that has been thrown to you, fall down and die. Fall down and die. Come on, somebody pray. The sword of faith, the sword of faith, and the shield of faith, the shield of faith, the shield of faith shall cover you from diseases, from poverty, from cancer, from diabetes, from arthritis, from every kind of accident, from COVID-19, from every poverty, from every demonic ignorance, in the name of Jesus. Every power of the darkness, as it is in the seed of faith, my faith will grow, my faith will grow. I'll be able to stand against every principality, against every stronghold. The Bible says that you submit to God, submit to God, resist the devil, and he will flee from you. I am seeing the devil free from you. I am seeing the devil free from you. I am seeing the devil free from you. Rikaba zakarakata, reka zakarakayanda, reka dabayanda rabaha, reka dakayanda raka, reka dararabosh, reka mazokoro botaya, reka mazakarakayanda, reka dadayanda ramayanda. I bring down every arrow of the devil. I bring down every arrow of the devil. I put the shield of faith. 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 Raka zakara kaya daraba. Mako zakara kaya daraba. Pigana iyo vita. 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 Makaya kara kaya daraba. Reka tara kaya daraba. How about to pick up my coffee? How about to pick up my coffee? How about to pick up my coffee? Kemea kira madabau, kemea kira gano, kemea kira gano, rikada kara kayanda, rikada kayanda rabosha, makosa kara kayanda raba, makotara kayanda rabosha, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Listen to this as we wind up. And having shod your feet with the preparedness of the gospel of peace, above all, taking the shield of faith, with which you will be able to quench the fiery darts of the wicked one, and take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. Our helmet covers the head. Helmet covers the head. And helmet talks about the spiritual covering. Hallelujah. The Bible says, and thy words shall be called salvation. Blessed are them that have received soteria. Salvation, the Hebrew meaning of salvation is soteria. It means to be rescued. It means to be saved from danger. And the first thing that we should have is that knowledge of Christ. Tukue na uwezo wa kujuana na Mungu. Tukue na uwezo wa kujuana, kujua njia za Mungu. We put the helmet of salvation. Wherever you are, shout, my father, my father. I put the helmet of salvation on my head. The devil will not be able to crack me in the name of Jesus. Siku moja kulikuwa, tulikuwa na mshirika mmoja wetu, alipata accident, alikuwa na anaendesha pikipiki na akapata accident mbaya sana, but Mungu ni mwaminifu sana, kwa sababu alikuwa amevaa helmet. Hakuna mahali kichwa yake iliguzwa, helmet yote ilipasuka, lakini kichwa yake haikupasuka. Na uzuri wa helmet ambao ni ya wokovu haiwezi pasuka, lakini inazuiria kichwa chako kutoka kwa defilement za kipepo, kutoka kwa defilement za shetani. Na nimekutangazia siku ya leo, as you go to the church, may salvation become your helmet today in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. May the word of God become the sword of the Spirit. Mahali pale tumesoma tukasikia we have the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. The Bible says in the book of Psalms 119, verses 130, unfolding of the word of God brings right. It brings understanding to the simple. Anytime that you hear the word of God, anytime that the word of God has been delivered to you, there is right that comes. The Bible says we are the light of the world. Why? Because we have the word of God. It is the word of God that makes, that dwells us, so that we can bring forth right. And when the Bible says in the beginning, when God created the earth and heaven, he said, and let there be light, in verse 3. And John speaks in the book of John chapter 1 that, and the light shined on the world, upon the world. That light is in us. As long as we have that light, which is Jesus Christ, who is the word of God, once we have that word, once we have the word of God, the simplicity of Jesus Christ, then we shine upon everything. The Bible says, the unfolding of the word of God brings light. It brings understanding to the simple. Isaiah 60 verses 1, arise and shine, for thy light has come. It is when you see the light that comes from the word of God that you shine. So the secret of shining is reading the word of God that builds your faith, and it builds light, it creates light. As you meditate the word of God, God told Joshua, and this book of the law, in the book of Joshua chapter 1 verses 8, and this book of the law shall never depart from your mouth. Meditate the word of God. Keep meditating the word of God. Pray scriptural prayers. As you meditate the word of God, unapoomba na Biblia, unapoomba na maandiko, you are able to defeat the powers of darkness. As you quote the word of God, as you meditate, you get light. The devil cannot be able to handle a man who reads the word of God. And then the devil cannot be able to handle a fiery man. The more you read the word of God, the better you become in terms of liberation. The better you become in the area of prayer. The more you ignore the word of God, the weaker you become. And it becomes a prey to the devil. And from today, you not become a prey to the devil in the name of Jesus. And I declare to you, as you go to the church, you are blessed, you are saved in the name of Jesus. No arrow of the devil will touch you. No demonic power will touch you. No evil act will touch you. And I declare, receive the new power, receive the new anointing in the name of Jesus. Wherever you are watching us from, I declare the favor of God to be upon you. I declare the favor of God upon your parents, upon your brothers and upon your sisters, upon your children and upon your husband, upon your wife. I declare the goodness and the mercies of God. You are blessed. You are saved. I declare, as you wear the full armor of the Lord, you'll be able to conquer this year. This year, them that will conquer are them that will align themselves with the will of God. Remember here, I said on that fast, that God is ready to release blessings, but only to them that have aligned themselves to the will of God. God bless you so much. My name is Apostle Murray William. I preach with Dominion City, Zimmerman. May God bless you. May God make his face shine upon you. You are blessed. Kama uko hapo kwa mgonjwa, na kama utawatch baadaye na uko mgonjwa, natangaza uponyaji wako saa hii katika jina la Yesu. Cancer disappear. HIV disappear. High blood pressure disappear. Asthma disappear. Disappear in the name of Jesus. Hypertension disappear. Diabetes, I command you to die in the name of Jesus. And I declare to you that you are protected. The blood of Jesus is enough for you. God bless you. We meet on the service. Shalom. Shalom.